Ladies and gentlemen, the singer of the millennium, Mr. Frankie Lane.
Surprise you, didn't I? And as usual, I surprise myself every time I come out here. It's no need for me to say that I'm very happy to be here. You may still be here, don't you? As George Burns used to say, happy to be anywhere. That's the way I feel. Thank you very much. We know that you're here mostly because you came to listen to a lot of the old, real old songs. And what are you doing? Nostalgia has been very good to us. I ain't knocking it. However, I hope you won't mind if we manage to sneak in maybe one or two items that really associated with me yet, but who knows? Somewhere down the line, it's still possible. However, I'm no dummy. I'm going to start with something real old. We'll go back to 1933. That's old. First made popular by Eddie Cantor on Broadway in a show, and then later on records, or maybe at the same time, I'm not sure. About 6 years ago, we decided to do an updated version of some of those old tunes to show what they could sound like, kind of like today. So we hope you like our version of his great hit, Making Another Bride, Another Jim, Another Sunny Honeymoon, Another Season, Another Reason for Making. Shoes, out of rest, who is this? The answer's nice. As we've been killing, he's so very well. We're making. Piece of material called Cement Mixer, Putty Putty. All of a sudden, Slim Gaylord is a star. and he's headlining at Billy Berg's. And because we used to work together, every night I was in there, he'd call me up to sing a song, hoping that somebody was in the audience that might hear me, that might like it, might do something. And this went on for weeks. No, months. Nothing ever happened. One night, he called me up to sing a song, and I happened to pick a song that was written by a guy who was in the audience, which I didn't know. Hoagy Carmichael. When I finished the song, he came running up the stage. He says, "What's your name?" I told him. He says, "Where are you working?" I says, "I'm not." He says, "Come with me." I says, "Where are you going?" He says, "I want you to meet Billy Berg." I knew Billy better than I knew him. So he said to Billy, he says, "Billy, this kid sings great. Why don't you put him to work?" Billy says, "What for?" He comes in and sings every night tomorrow. Which was true. I said, "Yeah." Rocking chair.
Pressing on my own.
to hear you whisper low. Just wait, it's time to go. Sherry, I love you so. You're my desire. Maybe I should have done it first. This can't be love because I feel so well. No sounds, no sounds, no sounds. This can't be love, forget no dizzy spell. My head is not the same. My heart does not stand still, just hear it beat. This is too sweet to be love. This can't be love because I feel so well. It's all I love to look in your eyes.
Richard!
Just hear it be. This is too sweet to be love. This can't be love because I feel so well. It's love. I love to look in your, love to look in your pretty brown, pretty brown, pretty brown eyes. I fell in love with you the first time I looked at them, their eyes. You've got a certain cute way of flirting them, their eyes. They make me feel so happy. They make me feel so blue. No stalling, I'm falling, falling in a great big way for you. My heart is jumping, it sure's got something in them, their eyes. You better watch them if you're wide, their eyes. And they sparkle and they bubble. Gonna get you in a whole mess of trouble. You're working in their brains, working in them. They're right,
Bobby. You better watch them if you're wise, little brown eyes. They sparkle and they bubble. Gonna get you in a whole mess of trouble. You're overworking and there's a danger lurking in them. Their eyes.
Dance or be ready on time. getting some wine. She bought foolish surprises. She didn't care what they cost, but she never could dance. So what am I lost? She never could sing. At least, not on key. And she never thought about herself. But only about me. She was always too willing. So I won't miss her too much. Blame it on the things she couldn't be. Blame it on most everything but me. She never would fight or pout very long, and her mouth was so sweet, and her chin was too strong. She was always the lady. She never could dance, so I won't miss her at all. No, she never could dance, so I won't miss her at all.
Thank you. Beautiful song. And when you figure it out, please come back and tell me what it is. In the mid-40s, the Hollywood studios were very busy making a lot of musicals. And it seemed like every songwriter in the country was heading for Hollywood, trying to get their songs into some musical. One of the prime guys, one of the prime composers, was a man named Jim McHugh. We recorded many of his songs. Great songs. Our favorite of everything he ever recorded is this one, On the Sunny Side of the Street.
Yeah. Grab your coat, get your hat. You know what rings on the doorstep. Just direct your feet over to Sunny Side of the Street. Can't you hear the pat? Old happy tune is your step. Life can be oh so sweet on the sunny side of the street. Well, I used to walk around the shade with all those blues on parade. Now I'm not afraid, 'cause I'm a robot who has crossed over. If I never have a cent, I want to be rich as old Mr. Rockefeller. Boulders at my feet on the sunny side of the street. Richard! Around the shade with all those blues and parade. now I'm not afraid, cause I'm a robot who has crossed over. And if I never have a cent, I'll be rich as old Mr. Rockefeller. Gold is at my feet on the sunny side of the street.
Music, this time with a song by the late great Hank Williams. Hank was a very peculiar talent, very, very powerful composer in many ways. Even though his songs sometimes only consisted of three or four chords, the whole thing, but they had that magic facility of being able to cross over into the pop field from the country field. Mitch Miller handed me one of Hank's songs back in 1953. And we must have done something right. We recorded. Today it has sold over 11 million copies. Well, I'm going to keep doing it anyway until it's a hit. Show these kids a thing or two. Don't laugh. You saw the way I was moving? Same way they do it. A little slower. Or does it last very long? Now.
Jezebel.
Yeah. If I do Jezebel, I'm done. Is that what you want? Okay, shut up. Now we, I'm just kidding. We have had a request to do a song which I love because I wrote it.
Wild Goose.
I wish it was. Whenever we get a request for takes precedence over everything else. Most of you, I'm sure, remember the name Carl Fisher. Carl wrote music. I did the lyric. It took me about 6 days to write the first 24 bars, and it took me 6 months to write the last 8. And it got a peculiar start. It took us a long time to get anybody interested in it. Everybody said it was too progressive, too advanced, hard on the ears. They couldn't accept the sequence of chords that seemed strange. But we finally broke through to the Pied Pipers, and they recorded it. And then Les Brown with the Doris Day vocals, she was wonderful. Meantime, I got lucky with Desire, and it happened, and this was our 3rd or 4th record. We recorded Shine, and this song wound up on the back of Shine. Shine was a million seller, so a lot of people heard it. And then Stan Kenton. Then the 4 Freshmen. And then Billie Holiday. And once she recorded it, it seemed like the gates opened. After that, it was Sinatra, Clooney, Bennett, Davis, everybody. To date, there are about 157 different recordings on this song. And all of us, put together, have not been able to make it a hit. Ha, ha, ha. But maybe some of you don't know it. I come from Sicilian people. And we, right? Never, never, never give up. So tonight, I'm gonna try again. And who knows? Maybe a spark will flare up amongst you. You won't be able to wait till the show's over to rush out to the nearest record shop to try and buy a copy of it. Don't bother, I've looked, there ain't any.
Together, again.
So how come you didn't buy it?
Around 1958, Charles Bud Dozier, one of the prime Hollywood studio producers, came up with an idea for a TV show in which he was going to use all completely unknown leads. And when he announced this to the public, they said that Charlie Bud had flipped his lid. But he thought that maybe a definitive theme song might hold the whole production together until the show got on. So he called in Dimitri Tiomkin and Ned Washington to write the song because they were very good at that sort of thing and had a tremendous hit in High Noon. So they left his presence in his office and came back in about 3 weeks and played the song for him. And he flipped. He says, "Fellas, this is a great, great piece of material. And as such, it deserves and demands to have a great, great singer do it." So they called in Roy Rogers. What did I know? I hadn't heard about it at this point. He didn't get it. Then somebody suggested Tom Jones. Good singer. But he was 6 years old. Gotcha. So he didn't get it. Then Dimitri called me. He says, "Maybe this will be the one for you. You missed High Noon. Maybe you can get this one." So I went in, I listened to it, and I flipped right away. I said, "Yes, I'll do it. Show me the first episode." So the first episode was a bunch of cows running at me. Followed by a bunch of guys on horseback. He says, "I'll do it." And that's how it came about. And Charlie said, "Well, it's not that easy, Frank." He says, "It's a little complicated situation. We want you to record the song first and have it come out on record. Because this TV show is going to need a lot of help." So, all right, call Mitch. It's Miller. And he had heard it. He says, "Yeah, man, that's great." So we got a wonderful group of guys behind me, and we made the song. Came out, went right to the top. And now we're waiting for the TV show to come out. They can't get a sponsor, so they hold the TV show back. So the producer, Charles Marcus Warren, called me. He says, "Frank, you got to pull the record back." "And how do you pull back a hit record?" I said, "Well, I'll call Mitch and see what he can do." So Mitch says, "Oh, cripes." That ain't what he said. But he held it back, and they stopped all the promotion. And finally, in January 1959, they got a sponsor. So the record came out again, went right to the top. And for the first 4 months, the record kept the TV show on the air. And then all of a sudden, it caught on. And it's kept me on the air ever since. By now, somebody hollers.
Waiting at the end.
cut them out. Ride them in rawhide. 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 Rawhide.
Now, Sarah Lady, my favorite piano. We hope you still love her as much as I do. She's been awfully good to me. Jezebel. Yeah.
Jezebel, it was you.
Jezebel, it was you.
Fair pair of eyes, promised paradise. Deceiving me, deceiving me, Jezebel. Made to torment man, it was you.
Jezebel, it was you.
Would be better had I never known all along,
such as you.
Oh, say he dreams along, oh, the silent fall of your arms. The demon love possessed me, you obsessed me, constantly. What evil star is mine, my fate's design should be.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been marvelous. And again, let me say how much we appreciate it and how truly grateful we are.
Lucky old guy.
It is very seldom that we are lucky enough to get a venue where everything seems to come together. The lights, the sound, the music, the audience, the stage, the physical surroundings, nothing but the best. And we'd be dummies if we didn't take advantage of it. So whenever that happens, we try to break in a new song. That's not a new song, dummy. But thanks for asking. This song was originally recorded by great singer Jack Jones. His lyric didn't quite fit the way I felt it should be written for me. So I fooled around with this for about 3 or 4 months, and finally came up with what I thought might be acceptable by the original writer. So I got a hold of the guy that wrote the lyric, and he says, do anything you want. So I called Benny, and I said, I think maybe I've got a working lyric on this song. We have tried it out the last 2 nights. People seem to have enjoyed it and liked it. So it may be that we're going to record it very shortly, and it may even be the title of the CD. It's called I Am a Singer.
Thank you. beyond the blend of the pines, while through the ever, never changing land, as silently as any native band that moves at night, the Angie's shine. And that is when I hear the song that only he can sing. So
chance.
Yeah, it's pretty great. Cool.